Hey guys, I'm BG Mike. Welcome back to Corpse Party. This is going to be starting, or I'm going to be starting, Chapter 2. And I remember Chapter 1, the ending was pretty crazy. I did not expect that ending. So if you guys have not watched it yet, please click on the card above me. That will link you to the playlist, and you guys can watch it all the way from number 1 if you're just tuning in. Thank you guys so much for coming back. Let's start up Chapter 2, shall we? Phew, that should just about do it. I hate being in charge of the gym equipment. So, we're in actual school, not in a haunted school. Oh good, it's the good old team, Naomi and Seiko. All because of that stupid co-ed meet in the 2 days. Why can't the boys' class rep take care of the grunt work? Yeah. Freaking Kishinuma. Doesn't he know that what a delicate flower I am? Most I've ever had to lift before was chopsticks, and he expects me to lug around a damned pommel horse? What the heck's a pommel horse? You guys know what that is? I don't know what that is. What is that? Naomi, that is one pretty size. Huh? What is? That booty you got! Why is Seiko always, like, commenting on our butts? She's totally lesbo, or just making, you know, like, gay jokes or something. What? Yours is way cuter! Is that what girls talk about? I have a feeling that's not how it goes. Mine's all plump, like a duck's butt. What are you saying? You've got what they call childbearing hips. It's a good thing. It means when you get older, you can pump out all the babies you want with the greatest of ease. I'm actually kind of happy to hear you say that. Are you, okay, if you're a girl watching this, are you happy when people tell you that? You do have a certain motherly quality to you, Naomi. Well, it's because we do take care of a lot of people, and I think that's why. I think Seiko wants that motherly quality. Maybe she doesn't have a mother. Who knows? It's no wonder you're so good with kids. But of course, I'm hoping to raise 4 children one day. Sounds like you'll be making some lucky guy real happy. Probably not, because I know what happened in the last episode. And how does this work? Is this part of the same reality? Yes, it is. Alright, I should not speak so soon. That just makes it even more sad. This is all bad, guys. Chapter 02, guys. Last episode, I said I ended chapter 2, even though I ended chapter 1, so sorry about that, guys. Sometimes I say things, and I don't realize what I'm saying. Wasn't that Nakashima's voice? Oh, I didn't know the teacher was here, too. And she was screaming. What do? I can't let anything happen to my students. Oh god, we're super teacher, aren't we? So we aren't the only people here, right? And this girl, Ayumi's probably been crying, for reals. Shinozaki, it's alright, please calm down. But you heard it too, outside, her voice. Oh, did they hear that we were, like, that Seiko was being hanged, right? That's Seiko, right? I think she's hyperventilating. I'd give her a paper bag to breathe into, but there aren't any around. I guess all I can do is try to calm her breathing before she passes out. It probably wasn't a real voice, I'm sure it just sounded like one. Maybe it was the building settling. Oh yeah, good excuse there, Miss Shishido. I'll go check it out though, and see if I can figure out what it was for sure. You two, stay right here, okay? Yui, wait! Don't leave us! I must. Shinozaki. Finally, freaking he says something. It's okay, Teach. I'll keep an eye on Shinozaki. Okay. Or better yet, how about I go take a look and you wait here? That'd probably be the more manly thing to do. What are you doing? My cat is, like, getting in the window. What are you doing? You better not be knocking over things. Okay. Not a chance until I verify one's safety, or everyone's safety. I want to keep you two out of harm's way. Well, okay, I guess. Be careful, though. Look, she'll be fine! Jeez! I'm counting on you, Kishinuma. I'll be back in no time. No problem. I have a bad feeling about him, Kishinuma. I'm actually scared. My legs are even shaking. I have no idea what's going on. My head is spinning. I can't make sense of anything. My chest hurts like my heart is encased in ice. And I can't shake this dizziness or this nausea. But when I think about the positivity of something horrible happening, or possibility, totally different use of words there, of something horrible happening to my dear students, I can feel a newfound energy welling up from within me. I feel like if nothing else, I can at least play the part of the level-headed adult. So, I noticed that everything's a different color, which does lead me to believe. One of you guys did comment that this game is about different dimensions and stuff, and I kind of getting that feeling right now. Valor, thy name is Education? What? Oh, so we're not using her. Alright then. So let's just go through here. Since it's the most... Oh god, what is this? I can't... it's a key, isn't it? A label on the key reads 3A. Take it. Alright, so the key to 3A. Sure, we can't go through here. No teachers allowed on the third floor? Wow, that was very specific notes. It's like we were meant to be here, right? Alright, I don't really feel like leading this, reading any of this stuff. What about here? Oh, that's 2A. We can't miss anything. Let's go in here. I like how the music's still the same, but it's a little different. I like the music a lot of this game. Alright, let's check this thingy. Nope, nothing. Nothing of use. Can we go out? The door seems affixed to the wall. Okay, I'm used to seeing that. Alright, enough of that. It is so dangerous with all these holes in the floor. They should really get them fixed. Oh, cool. This is where we need to be. Oh, it's this room with this is where the newspaper was, right? Hey-ya! Well, if it isn't the teacher, are you all by yourself? Decided to stop shaking and shivering with the other two back in 1A, did you? Oh, so they could see me. I'll have you know, I heard one of my students screaming, and I have set out to find her. I see. Regrettably. I don't know why, but this ghost doesn't seem like he wants to harm us. That won't be possible. This school exists in a nexus where multiple dimensions overlap, but it's a single closed space in a sea of closed spaces. See? Cool. You guys are right. In other words, even though you may be in the same school as your screaming student, you and she occupy different dimensions, which means you can never meet. But we can hear each other, so there must be some kind of connection, right? If one of you should die, perhaps your body or your spirit may move from one space to another, or... maybe you can find some means of traversing the planes freely as they do. Considering this fair warning, even if you should find the exact spot from which your student's scream emanated, she herself may not be there, and if she isn't, there's not a thing you can do about it. But I heard her voice! It is true that other children have been brought here quite recently, children who, by all appearances, are indeed your students. But, as I suggested, time and space do not behave as you'd assume here. They're fragmented. You say you heard a scream. That scream may have taken place only a few minutes ago. Or perhaps it occurred in another space many hours previous. It may even be an echo from the future. Who's to say? You never know. With this phenomenon, as it is, it's entirely possible for two close spaces to have some small influence on one another, even when out of sync. It doesn't matter, I can't just ignore that agonizing scream and go on my merry way. Step aside. Step aside, spirit. Oh wow, he really did. Cool. So it's quite refreshing to have a spirit that doesn't want to murder us and probably wear our face. Oh god. Now here's a red one. Step aside? Oh, why don't you F off, you damn corporeal? Okay, I take back what I said. He probably wants to wear our face. An earthquake? Is he the one making all the shakes? I gotta take a drink of water, guys. Oh! No! He did not just do that! What the heck? Bad fire guy! In all the world, the most vile and trustworthy individuals of them all are you school teachers. All you care about is your own well-being. You're not worried about your students, you're just worried about being held responsible if something should happen to them. This really, really hurts! It looks like it. You're all the same, every last one of you, and I won't be taken in by your lies anymore. Taken in? When you see a problem among your kids, you just keep your distance because you sure wouldn't want to get involved. You have to keep up appearances, right? You just pick out the problem children and chip away at them little by little until they either drop out or get expelled. You're not disciplining them, you're just raging at them. I admit some teachers probably do that, I'm sure they do. I've never met a teacher who actually cared about her students, not once. I have. You're wrong! Oh god. All of your students are destined to starve to death in these godforsaken halls if they don't succumb to depression and kill themselves first. There's no other possible outcome. They'll all die meaningless deaths, just like I did. And they sure won't be thinking about you when they take their final breaths. Oh god, this is brutal, guys. Any last words? Oh. I'll tell them to your students as I end their miserable lives. Oh, this is freaky. Come again? Spare my students! What was that? He's like, oh crap! Oh snap, she actually does care. This is my cat. You see this light on my face? Because my cat is like in the window. Come on! Get down, Scarlet. Please, I don't care what happens to me, just please spare their lives! They're not your children, you're not their mother. Are you really still pretending to care about them? Filthy liar. Did you know when you die in this accursed place, you experience the pain you felt at the moment of your death for all eternity? That's horrible. And I'm going to crush you to dust. The pain must be unbearable, unimaginable, and you're going to feel that pain every moment of every day forevermore. Ask me to spare you? It's what you really want, isn't it? Be honest with me, and I'll consider sparing your life. You know, we're gonna go out like a G, okay? Spare my students, yo! Don't you harm a hair on their heads, you hear me? You are one stubborn little... I'm not gonna say it, guys. Oh, we're still gonna die? This is excruciating. I think my ribcage is broken. It feels like someone's pushing this cabinet down on top of me with superhuman force. I'm losing consciousness. Does it hurt? Ah, oh, poor baby. Your corpse will look just like a dead frog on the side of the road. Everybody. Live. Ooh. I love you all. Dang, we went out like a G, for reals. Meanwhile. Oh god, what's happening meanwhile? Oh, we're gonna have to go find her too. Whoa, another earthquake? I think it's over. What's wrong? I just got a really bad feeling. You've got to go search for Miss Yui. Yeah, you need to. But maybe not. What if she comes back while we're gone? And we miss each other along the way? We're going! Okay! Alright, already. But if we don't have any luck finding her, let's just make sure we come back to this room, okay? where they don't want to squash us. How about we leave her a note? Shinozaki, do you have anything I could write with? I've got a pen. But no paper, huh? Well, there's always the teacher's desk. Is this the classroom that we started in? Miss Yui, we've gone to find you. If we pass each other and you see this message, wait right here. We'll be right back. How's that? Blunt and kind of sloppy. Oh god. Even in this time, she's like criticizing our handwriting. It's her fault we have to leave her a message at all, you know. But she might be in trouble. Okay, just don't cry. We'll find her. Alrighty then. Yes, we're gonna find her indeed, and it's not gonna be good. I look forward to it. Well, we might as well just cut to the chase, right? I notice every time someone dies, we can't do anything about it. What the? Looks like a dead end. Did this happen during that last earthquake? Sometimes these words are hard to read. Miss Yui, where are you? I'm really worried. Well, I guess we're not going through there, so screw that. Should I even dare go in here? Class 2A. Let's just try not to run into any more spirits. When you think they're good, they're not good. So that's like a lesson for you guys. You run into a spirit, just run away. Especially in an old building with lots of holes where you can break your ankle like I did. Okay. Well, okay, now I remember. It did say no teachers, and we're not teachers, so I guess we can just go on through here. Now, I do wonder, are we going to actually meet our teacher's spirits along the way? And is she going to help us, or is she going to want to kill us? Probably want to kill us. Oh! God. What the? Well, never mind then. A crude picture seemingly drawn by a child adorns one of the shelves. Oh! That is pretty crude. Four smiling children are surrounding an adult and merrily stabbing him to death. Was that the principal? How unsettling. Yeah. Your kid draws that, you need to tell somebody. Okay, I thought I'd try it again. It didn't work. Well, let's read this. If you acquire any name tags from the corpses in the school, please bring them to me. I'll add them to my collection. The custodian. Oh, what does a custodian want with name tags? What the heck? Why did that make noise just now? So, I guess we go back. Maybe something different will happen. Okay, so we're gonna try going down in hopes to find something. Oh, is this where the stupid infirmary is? Oh, buckets! You guys know we need a bucket just in case someone tries to hang themselves. There's a strange yellow fluid congealing inside the rusted bucket. So that hasn't changed. And we can't pick it up anyway. Oh, so this is just the other side of the classroom, I see. So how do we get over here? Okay. Wait, is there... Oh, well. I'll check later. I was gonna see if there's a door on the other side. Oh god, what does she want now? Is she gonna cry some more? What's up? I just had a brainstorm. Class rep Shinozaki's famous scary time candles. They're not a student in 2-9 who isn't intimately familiar with them, right? You kidding? There's not a student in our grade who hasn't seen them at least once. People call you the honor or the horror rep for Kisaragi for a reason. So how about... We light some candles like this all throughout the school building. Oh, I understand now. Those candles were in chapter 1, so they were left there by her. So I think as the more we play this game, we're going to notice how things are going to be coming together. And that should be interesting. They'll be like signal flares for Mochida and the others. Let them know what you and me and Miss Shishido are here, all here with them, safe and sound. Okay. Yeah, I guess. But we didn't say anything when we saw them, right? At least not that I remember. Seems more like she's just trying to reassure herself that she's okay. But if that makes her feel better. Come on, let's go. Okay. Whatever makes us feel better, right? Oh, I don't like this music already. All bad. Nothing good's gonna come out of this. I can already tell you. Ooh, shoes. Oh my god, shoes. You guys remember that stupid video? It was like so popular. Oh, lots of corpses. These are human bones. I hope so. Oh god, no. Oh, come on, they're just bones. I mean, I know if there was like a bunch of guts, I'd understand it's like to throw up and stuff. Are you okay, Shinozaki? I'll be fine. I'm just hyperventilating a little. Come on, we have to find Miss Yui. Yeah, oh god. The thing that sucks is that I know what happened to her, so it's like, I don't want them to find her. Where the hell is Satoshi? If he were here, I bet Shinozaki would be a whole lot calmer. Does everyone like Satoshi? What are you standing around for? Let's get out of here. Alright, already! You can tell that our character is just not having it. He doesn't care. Oh, where should we go, though? Oh, god, someone recently just died. There are decaying skeletal remains here about the size of a middle school student. They're in the process of slowly drying and whitening, creating an almost overpowering stench throughout the hallway. And any clothing the deceased had been wearing is long gone, so there are no means of readily identifying gender on site. Victim's Memoirs, 1 of 5. I ate my friend today. Wow, what a way to start off. What else was I supposed to do? I was starving. We both were, and there's no food here, so we decided together that one of us should try to live just a little bit longer. If I ever get home, I'm supposed to tell all the people waiting for us what happened. Imagine having to tell, like, your mom and dad or the person, your friend's parents, hey, I had to eat your son or your daughter today. It wasn't very good. We left it all up to the game of paper, scissors, rock. Don't put it in that order. It's rock, paper, scissors. Okay? I think in Japan it's different, so that's probably why it's like that. Loser eats winner. God, that's like the rock, paper, scissors game of your life. Like, that's the one rock, paper, scissors game that you do not want to lose. Like, oh my god. Did they at least make it 2 out of 3? I hope so. And I lost. Like, just imagine the first one losing. Okay, alright, 2 out of 3. Oh god, that's what I'd be like. I felt her blood going down my throat, quenching my thirst, and her meat was supple and satisfying. Oh, so it was a girl. But that blood and that meat was once my friend, up until just a few hours before I'd been talking with her. As I feasted, I just kept thinking this food used to be a person before I tore it apart. It all worked together to sustain a life. And every time I thought about that, I just started crying and I couldn't stop. I wanted some part of her to be with me even after she died, so I decided to keep one of her eyeballs. That's... what? And I thought maybe I should write all this down to help her preserve some small portion of my sanity. That's tough. I mean, there's a lot of meat on a person. I think you can save both their eyeballs. If I were to go as far to eat a person to survive and like they were cool with it and I was cool with it, even though I don't think that would ever happen, I think I would leave the eyeballs alone because that's just nasty. That's like eating a fish eyeball. I wouldn't do it. What kind of classroom is this? What the hell kind of room is this? It's not like any classroom I've ever seen. Why is she falling again? Come on. Hey, Shinozaki! My head is splitting. Are you okay? God, you take you to the hospital. We shouldn't be here. We really shouldn't be here. It looks like there's something in here, though, in the back. Alright, let's check it out, guys. Oh no! It's a little boy! God, Oh my god, is this the person who ate that other person? What the hell? Stay back! Huh? Don't scare me like that, jeez. You are absolutely, positively must not look into his eyes, okay? Why? Alright. Alright, so it's like Pokemon, you know, you don't want to look them in the eyes or they'll want to fight you. A rusted, blood-soaked nail puller is sitting on top of the desk. Take it? Yes. But I want to look him in the eyes to see what happens. Acquire the nail puller. Is that just like a hammer? What is that over there, though? We're going to save it here because I want to look him in the eyes to see what happens. Because you don't want to miss any secrets. Alright. Now, let's look some ghosts in the eyes here. Or maybe not. Can we go over here? I mean, come on. He's a little kid. What's the worst that could happen? Don't let your gaze meet his. How does she know about ghosts? Alright, I did it. Damn it, I looked and now I can't look away. What the hell is up with his eyes? Oh god. His tongue's gone. What's going on? It's pitch black. Shinozaki! Miss Yui! Satoshi! Is anyone there? Man, where the hell am I? Was I dreaming or something? I can't move. Feels like walls all around me. Am I in a hole or something? Oh, God. What the? Who's? Oh, God, they're burying me. Stop! What the hell? I'm alive down here! You're planning to suffocate me? My mouth is getting totally filled up. Oh, God. Well, I can't breathe. Am I going to die like this? With the previous history of this game, you're probably gonna die like that. This isn't funny. Stop it. My eyes are really hurting. God, the noises, though. Oh god, how much longer is this gonna keep going? Oh, okay. Well, if you guys didn't know what happens if you look into that ghost's eyes, that's what happens. So good thing we can just load it up here, so we're alright. We are alright. Alright, so we got a nail puller. Now we gotta find nails. Okay, so we know it's in there, and we're gonna just go on this way now. I don't think we went in here. No, never mind. We're not going in there. Forget it. We're not going in there either. Did we see this before? Based on the long strands of hair scattered all around, these are likely the remains of a female student. There's a hastily written note on the ground. Its writers seem to have struggled with it, as the lettering is inconsistent and difficult to read. Why, sister? It hurts, it hurts. After I die, the pain will continue forever. No. No, no, no. Oh, not! Sis, you lied to me. You're going to leave me behind, aren't you? I will never forgive you. Alright, so maybe we shouldn't bother that spirit. Maybe we shouldn't. Let me see how long we've been going here. Okay, we have a little bit longer to go. God, I want to save again because like I don't want to miss things. Alright, what the heck? Let's just talk. I hate you, sister. It hurts. Yeah, you're not really great at writing poems either. They're pretty depressing. Custodian's closet. The door is locked. There is an erratic noise like that of a TV static. Okay, so it was like that last time too. Alright, pointless. All pointless so far. So let's go on back. This music is creepy. It's creeping me out just a little bit. Alright. Oh. Oh god, why does she look weird? What is it? She looks weird as crap. I mean, it's like really weird graphics, but she looks weird. Hey, where are you going? What the hell was that all about? Great! As if things were not bad enough, now she's all weird. She's probably possessed. Shinozaki, are you... What are you... Oh, I've seen that picture. No one is saying that! No one is saying what? Today's my daughter's birthday. She's turning 7. We're going out together to celebrate. Are you now? What are you doing? That's disgusting. Why are you both looking at me like that? Well, what do I say? This is getting awkward. Each time you turn around, stop for a moment and ask yourself, is the world behind your back still there? Intriguing. Shinozaki? Hey! Hey, girl. Let's get it together, alright? Huh? Kishinomaki? Oh, she's all normal now. What the heck? What's wrong? You were saying some pretty weird stuff just now. Was she not aware? Must be the pressure. Her nerves are probably shot all the hell by now. Never mind. Probably just my imagination. Don't worry about it. Completely fine. Normal. That's pretty much the definition of the school is normal. All fine. All good. Just peachy. Oh, you! You are not going to be getting me today. God! don't let it touch you. How does she know about the ghost? Is it going to follow us or what? What's going on? Can we go through here? No. Oh, so that's the front of the school. Holy crap, I just realized that. Oh! Ah! Stay away from us! Okay, he's following us. I don't like it. Okay, he's slow. He's really slow. So we just have to keep running. It's alright. I'm not even scared of a slow ghost. It's like Michael Myers, you know? This walks really slow, but hopefully, eventually it won't catch us like that. That usually happens. Why am I going this way, though? I'm just kind of running and not thinking about where I'm going at all. I hope it's still not following us, and I'm about to find out. God. Oh, God. I'm, like, going down, like, kind of looking every time. Okay. It's scary. I'm getting kind of freaked out in real life, to be honest. I don't know why. These games, like, the graphics aren't even that good, but the noises and everything else is kind of enough to freak me out. How do you guys feel about that? Hey. Oh, no, 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 come on. Why would they need a flyer for this? I wasn't even reading it. I didn't know it was going to go to a cutscene or something. Yeah, seriously, who's going to kill themselves in here? I'd rather find my own way out. So that's basically what the flyer said. I thought it'd be more important than that. I guess it wasn't. Oh, crap. Okay, so we try to go through the door. It's cold in here. Not to mention dark and scary. Hey, Shinozaki. Do you have any more of those candles, like the one you lit during the ghost story? I do. How about we light one up and take a quick breather? They give off some heat, right? Sure. Where does she keep them? In her skirts? Or what? Okay, I don't want to know. You know, this candle of mine really is kind of warm. Yeah, it is. Oh, that's not good. Well, guys, I think we're going to be saving it here. Alright, I think this is a great place to end. It's kind of on a cliffhanger, and I hate when I watch things and it ends on a cliffhanger, but it kind of makes you want to watch more, right? Anyway, guys, this episode's probably going to be a good 35, 40 minutes long, so yeah, I think it's a good place to end it here. Well, I can't wait, guys, to see what lies beyond this door next episode. I'm sure it's going to be hugs, kisses, probably candy, you know, lots of warmth and goodness and stuff. So I just can't wait to see that, guys. I probably upload another one tomorrow or maybe Thursday. I'm not really sure, guys. If you don't know my schedule, you can check it in the description. It kind of gives you an idea of what I'm going to do so you guys know what's going to be coming out. And for the ones who like to watch Yandere Simulator, it comes out on Saturday. Just saying. Once again, guys, if you have missed any episodes and you want to watch more, click the eye. You probably have to click the screen and then you would find the eye up here somewhere. You click that and it's going to take you to the playlist that I have linked in this video, guys. Thank you so much. If you have not subscribed, please do subscribe. It helps me out a lot. Leave a like and I will see you scrubs in the next episode. Bye, guys.